Hey there, and welcome to the channel. My name's Nick, and in this video, I'm going to walk you through how to create a staging site on WordPress.com. Now, a staging site is basically a copy of your live WordPress site that you can use to safely test changes, whether it's a new theme, a plugin, maybe some design updates, all without touching your actual production site. They're a great way to troubleshoot issues, preview beta WordPress releases, or even collaborate with clients and colleagues on some upcoming changes to your site. Staging sites are a key part of many web development workflows, so let's jump in and take a look at how they work on WordPress.com. All right, here I have a site, and it's called Push to Prod. It's a fictitious development blog currently running on the WordPress.com business plan. Now, let's say that I want to make some design changes to this site. Perhaps I want to change the color of the links, and instead of just exposing my design experimentation to actual site visitors, I'm going to use a staging site instead. So to do so, I'm going to head over to the site overview. Now again, you'll notice that I'm using the business plan. This is important because staging sites are only available on business and commerce plans. Then I'm going to head over to the staging site tab on my site dashboard. Note that you can only create one staging site per production site. But let's create one, and we're going to click Add Staging Site. It does take a bit for staging sites to be created. You can navigate away from this window if you so choose. You'll get an email notifying you whenever the process is done. But for the sake of the video, I'm going to speed this up a little bit, and we can see here that the staging site has been created. And once it's been created, you can navigate to it by just clicking on the Manage Staging Site button, or it's also available in the sidebar. And then once we get to the new dashboard, it's going to look very similar to our production site. It's just going to be outlined in yellow. And then we can go to the staging sites tab, and there's a handy button that lets you switch back and forth. So if you're on your staging site and you want to go back to production or vice versa, it's very easy. Let's check out what this staging site looks like. Well, let's go to WP Admin, and then we can visit the front end of the site. And sure enough, it looks exactly like the production site did. So let's make a change to this staging site. We'll go over into the site editor. And now what we want to change are the blue links here, the link color. So to do so, we're going to go to Global Styles. We're going to open up the Global Styles panel, scroll down to Color. And what we'll do is we'll change the palette, the color palette, so we can change that. And then let's modify the blue color. I don't know, maybe we'll do a purple. And then we'll change the second color blue to a deeper purple. And that will kind of be the hover effect on our links. Once we're happy with that, we can go and click Save. All right, let's go back to the site's dashboard and go to our production site. And we'll take a look at it on the front end. Obviously, nothing should change yet because we haven't synced any changes and the links are still blue. Go back to sites. And down below, you're going to see some options to synchronize content back and forth between staging and production. And there's a lot of options here. And it's important to kind of go through them in detail. Because when you sync changes from staging to production, you have all the options that you see here. When you go from production to staging, what it's going to do is going to take everything in production and overwrite your staging site. So when you go from production to staging, it's just a full copy of production to staging. But when you come back, WordPress.com gives you all sorts of options to fine tune how you want that synchronization to happen. So for example, if you added a new theme and you only want to bring the theme over, you could just do theme files and directories. Same for plugins. Also, if you just added a few new images in your staging site, you want to sync those, you can do the same thing with media uploads. And you have the additional options here. Now, the one that's outlined in red is actually the one that we're going to be using right now. And that's because changes to global styles in the site editor are actually saved to the database. Now, it is important to take care when you sync the database because that's going to overwrite the database in production. Now, there are some points that you need to be aware of, especially related to WooCommerce. If you're syncing a store back and forth between staging and production, there's a lot of great detail in the documentation. There's a link in the description of this video. So let's go ahead and before we actually do the synchronization, I want to show you that you can do the same thing whether you're in your production site or you're within your staging site. So if we go back to our staging site, you'll see that we have this exact same options. So no matter where you do it, it doesn't matter. Just know that you can do it from either staging or production. We're going to check site database again because the color palette changes are actually stored in the database. And we're going to click synchronize. You're going to be asked to confirm the change. And once you do, just click the synchronize button. Now, again, depending on what you're syncing, this process can take a little bit of time. I've sped it up for the sake of the video. And we can see here that the synchronization is complete. Now, to check that it actually worked, what we're going to do is let's go to the front end of the staging site. And it should be our purple links. And here we are, we have our purple links. But now we'll go to that production site and we'll refresh the page. And sure enough, our links are now purple. So you've seen how easy it is to make some changes in your staging site and then sync those back to production. And this is probably the most common workflow that you'll run into when working with staging sites. However, it is important to note that a staging site actually has nearly almost all the functionality of a production site, including integrations to other developer tools on WordPress.com, like GitHub Deployments. It also has some unique features, such as allowing you to test out beta WordPress versions that you can't do on a production site. So let's check those features out. All right, we're back on the dashboard for the staging site, and you can see all the different functionality that's here. One of my favorites is GitHub Deployments. This allows you to deploy a plugin or a theme from GitHub and test it out on your staging site before you end up using it on your production site. There's a link in the description for more details on GitHub Deployments. Well, you also can see we have monitoring and performance. And then under settings, you're going to find all the familiar features like accessing the database, you know, your SSH keys, that sort of thing. I will note that your SSH keys for your production site will be different from those on staging, so you'll have to regenerate those credentials on staging if you need the feature. And then under server here, you can see that you do have access to beta WordPress releases. So this is a great way to test the latest and greatest that's coming with WordPress without testing that on your actual live production site. So after you started playing around with staging sites, have a look around to see all the different features and functionality that is available. And then you can get your site all ready to go before you make those final changes back to your production site. So now you know how to add a staging site to your business or commerce plan here on WordPress.com and the many ways that you can use this feature. I hope you found this video useful, and if you did and you're watching on YouTube, consider liking the video and subscribe to the channel for more developer-oriented content. Finally, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one. Have a great day.